This segment brought to you by Kansas Regenerative Medicine Center. Your stem cells, your health, your life.
Good morning. Welcome to Around Kansas. I'm Deb Goodrich, and with me this morning is our dear friend and Around Kansas contributor, Michelle Martin. Good morning, Michelle.
Good morning, Deb. Good morning to all our viewers. I'm glad to be here in Kansas with you today.
We are at the Fort Wallace Museum this morning because we've had a lot of events recently, and Michelle was one of our speakers at a symposium we had a couple of weeks ago, along with Henry Crawford from Lubbock, Texas, our friend Sharon Houston from Manhattan, and a local favorite, Mark Berry, who's just an incredible historian and presenter. And we just had a great time. And this is just the first of events we will do all year, marking our theme of harvesting the plains. So we had a lot of focus on buffalo hunting. Michelle actually spoke about a book that she co-wrote with Kansan Bill Kurtis, the Prairie Table Cookbook.
Yes, I had the opportunity to share with folks how people ate in the plains, from the American Indian people to the military, our pioneers and homesteaders, and our chuck wagons and ranch houses. It was great.
It was so much fun. And the book is sadly now out of print. You might be able to scrounge one on Amazon or an estate sale or something, mm-hmm. if you're fortunate. It was a beautiful, beautiful book. I sure wish they would reprint it, but we shall see. We shall see. Well, today is a very important moment in history, especially for Fort Wallace. For on this day in 1840 in Ireland, Miles Walter Keogh was born. And Miles Walter Keogh, perhaps the handsomest officer ever in the U.S. Army. Would you say so?
He gets my vote hands down.
Yeah, he really does. He was something.
Ladies, if you have not seen Miles Walter Keogh, yeah, please Google. You'll be glad you did.
We should sell like 8x10 glossies or something.
Miles, we should. Keogh.
That would be a great fundraiser. Mm-hmm. All right. So speaking of Irishmen, this is one of the auction items that we had that we auctioned raising money for the museum. This is a Guinness bottle from the 1860s, and I actually have one at home, but what is so significant about the Guinness bottle, and what we're so tickled to find, when we were going through bottles, our friend Ross Roberts came up and helped me sort bottles. We found a Guinness bottle that was among those discarded bottles from the post. So I messaged the archive in Dublin. Guinness Brewery has its own mm-hmm. archive. It is the oldest continuously operated brewery in the world, and they have their own archivist, and I messaged him, and he said, yep, that's a Guinness bottle. We started making that label in 1862. So I messaged a friend of mine in Ireland who is a Keogh expert, and I said, did Keogh drink Guinness? And he's like, well, duh. And I said, well, that's what I thought, but being a historian, you need solid sources. You mm-hmm. need somebody else to say it. You can't just go on your own gut instinct. So it is confirmed Keogh did drink Guinness. So
Guinness is good for you.
I'm dying to just connect that, you know, put that Guinness bottle in Keogh's hand and mm-hmm. touch his lips.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. So we have a wonderful show for you today. Find some time in the day. Maybe it's a little too early. I have Irish coffee this morning.
Ooh.
Might be a little early in the day for a toast, but sometime today, let's toast our Irish knight, Miles Walter Keogh. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Miles.
In 1821, a trade route was opened from Missouri in the United States across prairies and mountains to Mexico. In 2021, we will mark 200 years of epic conflicts and grand adventures, larger-than-life personalities, and sweeping landscapes. Join us on an historic journey. The Santa Fe Trail lives on.
Find us on social media or santafetrail.org.
Okay, looks like it's time for our tour. Welcome to the Fort Wallace Museum. Here at the museum, you're going to find some really interesting stuff, like our replica stagecoach from the Butterfield Overland Dispatch. We've got facades from the fort buildings. We've got an 1870s flag. There's a plesiosaur that was discovered locally. We've got the Ray pump organ collection. We're a little bitty place with a great big story, and we'd love to have you.
My name's Karen Coe.